cause I know you got soul. Listen if you're missing, y'all. Swing it while I'm music
hitting y'all. What's up, everybody? It's Tyler Thompson, BYN TV Live. We're here with Professor Griff. He's public speaking on hip-hop and what we need to do in our lives. Check it.
All right, hi. Professor Griff.
Peace, good.
He represented I Remix Radio. I'm Jose Harris. So I just wanted to ask you a few questions about what you do and why you do it.
Okay.
So do you still rap today?
Yeah, definitely. Got to spit. I mean, that never stops. You always got to tell the stories. You already got to pass down the oral tradition. I write every day. Even if I'm not putting the song out, I still write it. And that's what we should do as hip hop artists. Definitely as artists, period.
All right, so. Well,
but would you ask a painter that? If a painter has an easel and the canvas set up, you know, wherever they have it set up at, and they're painting, you know, when you get inspired to paint, you paint.
Well, what made you decide to start talking to kids about hip hop and what they see in the media?
I think because as I've seen the negative influence of hip-hop, how it affects young people, I think, as opposed to putting it in a song, which a young person probably would never hear, I said, well, let me just go be upfront and personal with them and talk to them about it, see what's on their mind, interact with them about certain things, and yeah.
All right. Well, many people are probably wondering what you think about Flavor Flav, as he used to be a member of Public Enemy. And
well, he still is. He still is a member of Public Enemy, but I think there's a lot of Flavor Flavs out there, and there's a lot of people out there that that have been brought to Public Enemy via Flavor Flav. So a lot of people were attracted to Flavor Flav, and they came and they were attracted to him, and Flavor brought those people to Public Enemy so Public Enemy could teach them. That was a pivotal role that Flavor Flav played in Public Enemy. What Flavor decided to do with his solo career on TV, radio, and on the CDs that he decided to make, I guess that's a conscious decision that Flavor Flav had to make. But now, what I feel about it, of course I look at it as, you know, a degree of buffoonery, a degree of setting black people back. Of course, setting Public Enemy back, because what we taught was not to be that person. You understand what I'm saying? So for him to come and get an audience of 7.5 million viewers, of course it's going to make our job a lot harder. Although we love Flavor Flav and he's still our brother, there's some things, some people in the family that need to be checked.
Okay, so you think he's actually going against what you
Of course, definitely. You don't think so?
I think he is.
Okay.
So, but then in that case, how is he still a member of Public Enemy?
He's still a member of Public Enemy simply because your physical brother in your family may have done things that your mom and dad and your uncles and your aunties didn't like, and the brothers and sisters didn't like. All right, so when he came back home from jail or got himself together or whatever, did you kick him out of your family?
No.
No. You embrace him, you bring him back in, hopefully that person will do better the second time around. So that's what we're hoping with Flavor Flav.
All right. Well, who do you see as some of the positive rappers out nowadays?
Wow. That's a very good question. I like what I'm hearing from Lupe Fiasco, although I don't like the N-word being used. I like what I'm hearing from Gnarls Barkley. I like what I'm hearing from certain aspects of what Common does and what Nas does. I definitely like what I'm hearing from Wise Intelligent, from Poor Righteous Teachers, NY Oil, Immortal Technique, Gene Gray. And these are some of the artists that I have in my iPod. You understand what I'm saying? I've always loved what Rage Against the Machine is doing. So these are some of the artists that I like.
What would be your advice to somebody like Common or Nas or Lupe Fiasco?
I'd say to them, let's dialogue. And if Nas and Lupe Fiasco and Common and the rest of y'all are watching this, hopefully you will, call me, dude. Let's dialogue. Let's get on the same page so we can go after the hearts and minds of our people. I'm not trying to knock your hustle. I'm just saying you got to do what you got to do to eat and to feed your family. But no one understands there's other people eating and feeding off of what you say and do. So we have to be conscious about what we say and do. Do you understand what I'm saying? So the Gnarls Barkley and the Commons and the Nas and them kind of cats, call me, man. Let's dialogue. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we can preserve hip-hop and put the four fundamental elements back into hip-hop. All right.
Some of the more conscious rappers are saying that hip-hop is dead. Mm. Do you believe hip-hop is dead, or do you think it's still
hip-hop
alive?
Hip-hop is energy. Energy cannot be created nor destroyed. So you can't destroy hip-hop. So those rappers that are saying hip hop is dead like Nas, they're probably talking about this madness that we think is hip hop. You understand what I'm saying? Which is not hip hop. Definitely not hip hop.
So what is
hip hop? Hip hop is higher infinite power healing our people. Higher infinite power healing our people. Hip hop is an energy. Hip hop is a positive frequency. Hip hop is the voice of the voice.
Many people are probably.
Hi, this is Todd Thompson with Iris Radio, and we're here with Professor Griffin for an interview. Okay, so what? How do you feel that being a part of the Public Enemy group has influenced the rest of your life?
Wow, I think being part of Public Enemy has created a platform and a stage and a medium in which I can get through to young people ideas that I have, positive ideas that I have. So if it wasn't not for Public Enemy and hip hop, I probably wouldn't even be at the school today. You understand what I'm saying? Because that's the medium, that's the underground railroad, so to speak, that I came in on. Yeah.
So what message do you want to get to all the kids that you talk to or that you meet at places like this or events like this?
Well, my slide presentation of about 300 slides, the message I'm trying to get across is let's interact with hip-hop in a different way that's being portrayed in the media right now. Let's interact with hip-hop and let's truly elevate our higher consciousness by taking the songs, interpreting the songs, and expressing those ideas that we're getting through the songs in a positive way. Another message I want to convey is the fact that we're actually gods and goddesses. And we need to activate the higher God consciousness. You understand what I'm saying? I know it's deep, but those are some of the messages I want to convey. Definitely.
Okay. So what about hip-hop do you think? How does hip-hop affect people? And how has it affected people in history?
Well, hip-hop has allowed people to express themselves. And those positive songs that have came out via hip-hop have benefited people's lives. Nearly the amount of people that I could probably mention to you that Public Enemy lyrics have affected people in prison, in hospitals, in the hood, in projects, throughout the globe. Everywhere we go, France, Italy, Rome, Australia, Amsterdam, London, all of these, Japan, all of these places that we visit, we're looking at the end result of what our songs have done for people.
How do you feel that hip hop has changed throughout its history and throughout time from back when it first started to now?
Hip-hop has changed a lot simply because this thing that we're going through now, we that have put the four elements of hip-hop in place, we don't even look at this madness as being hip-hop. It's ish-hop, S-I-S-H-I-T, hop. You understand what I'm saying? Or strip-hop, what Beyonce is doing. And we don't even look at it as being hip-hop. When Lil Wayne could come up with a song, how does this song, and that's my DJ. My DJ, with no DJ in the video, how was that hip-hop? So no aspect of what these people are talking about is hip-hop.
What do you think needs to be done to bring hip-hop back to where it started?
These rappers need to live up to their own words as far as keeping it real. You understand what I'm saying? And just be real. And just keep it real. And take the four elements of hip-hop and keep it in the music so we can learn. So you can benefit from it. How old are you?
12.
I got a daughter 12 years, about a little bit taller than you. You understand what I'm saying? If I continue to let her listen to Lil Wayne and all these other cats, she's not going to know what hip-hop is about.
How do you think that hip-hop is affecting the youth nowadays?
In a very negative way, because these cats are always talking about bagging chicks, getting money, bringing drugs in. You understand what I'm saying? Now, there's some songs out there that are cool, but the vast majority of this thing called hip-hop today is very negative. WGCI and some of these other radio stations should be ashamed of themselves, playing the same 13, 14 song every day. Same songs. So yeah, it's affecting them in a negative way. The proof of that is, let's look at some of the things that are going on that's affecting young people that they learn from some of the hip-hop songs. A lot of rappers are still getting incarcerated, busted for drugs, because if you're bringing in so much money, why are you still selling drugs? So we need to explore that concept and that aspect of hip-hop.
All right, thank you for your time.
Give thanks, really appreciate that.
I got one more.
Music hit your heart, cause I know you got soul. Listen if you're missing, y'all. Swing it while I'm singing. Hey! Give it what you're getting. Know what I know.